9-year-old Chicago boy becomes a blessing for the homeless, Fox lawsuit, and much more this week on The Sevens. What's up, y'all? Welcome to this week's On The Sevens. Whew, glad to be back on the green, and I'm not talking about the golf course. But before I start rambling, let's go ahead and get into business. This week, Fox is under scrutiny for a huge debacle of a law. Let's try this again. A discrimination lawsuit? Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. 13 current and former anchor persons are, of course, behind this. And we all know it's going to grow from there because Fox, woo, we know they're good for some discriminatory acts, right? They name a long-term comptroller, Judith Slater, that she has been making some racially insensitive comments. Well, me being a black woman in corporate America, I know about those. All I want to say is good luck to those, and hopefully justice will be served. ESPN is doing major layoffs. And of course, it comes to a huge shock for some because just looking at how long they've been with the company, 21 years plus, like, that's deep. We'll all miss a lot of these anchor people, and I'm not even going to lie, like, I'm not even an ESPN watcher, but I'm just saying for job security purposes, like, that must be really difficult to deal with. But the reason why they're being laid off is because now a lot of these shows are being streamed, and ESPN funnels a whole lot of money into putting all that network beautifulism all on your screen. So, if you are now part of the now streaming generation, then of course you're part of the problem. Just kidding. But in all seriousness, I want to say hopefully all those journalism folks get to find another position that will get them going in their career. And also, let's also take this in consideration. If you're at a job and you've been there for a really long time, make sure you save your money, because at any time, they could lay you off. Can't be good. In local news, a 9-year-old Jaquiel Jackson from Chicago is passing on blessings to homeless folks. So it started when he was just 6 years old, and he went down to Lower Wacker Drive with his aunt and fed the homeless. From there, he said, "It feels like I don't want anyone to be homeless, so I want to do whatever I can to help these people." So he makes blessing bags. He gives them all their necessities, things that they need just to start their morning and end their day. If you want to be a part of this non-for-profit organization, you can always go to his website, iamnaeem.com, and go ahead and donate your time. And also, you can start this program for any of the local kids in your neighborhood to go ahead and give back. Because you know what they say, a child who gives usually does better in school. If you don't believe me, check the statistics. Also, this Saturday, More Than Your Kidneys, non-for-profit organization, is having a benefit at Mercy Hospital. Begins at 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. and it's put on by CEO and founder Darvis Munson. Now come on through and give your donation. She's an advocate for any type of diseases that are going on in the community as far as giving that education. And she's also honoring the people who do have these diagnoses, but is not living by what they've been diagnosed with. So giving them some positive things to go for. So go ahead and check it out. We're gonna have karaoke, have a silent auction, a little dancing, maybe even have a couple of drinks. But just go have a good time and tell them Convo sent you. In world news, an 11-month-old was killed by her father. So in Thailand, there is a mother and a father, and they got into a little argument. He was saying that his girlfriend was cheating, but he wasn't really sure. And from that argument, he killed his daughter. He hung her over the banister, put a noose around her neck, and threw her from the banister. Wow. I'm sorry. And he took her body and turned it off. But the thing of it about it is, it was on Facebook Live. Again, on Facebook Live. But we're going to come back to that. After the camera was turned off, he then hung himself. Now, coming back to the Facebook Live death again, I just want to put out there, why is it that we keep seeing people die on Facebook Live and yet it's still not being pulled yet? It's only so much money that can be profited from the demise of other people. How many more people have to die in order for you to pull Facebook Live? Is it that serious? My other question is too, I haven't seen the video. Not that I want to see that graphic video, but when that 79-year-old man was killed, that was online for 24 hours straight. Everyone in the world saw that video. Why is that? A girl got gang raped on Facebook Live. Everyone saw that. My point is, and I'm just gonna say it, if it has to do with a black life being killed on a live camera, it's gonna be shown. And that should make you as uncomfortable as it's making me. So I'm saying to Mark Zuckerberg and all the other big wigs of these companies, shut it off. Moving on. In entertainment, my girl Paris Jackson has finally emerged from under a cover. So we all know that, you know, she is the daughter of Michael Jackson, and she, at first she didn't want to be in the limelight, but now she is. She's actually a model for IMG. Go ahead, girl. Get it with your bad self. But she's also saying that she's becoming a model because she wants to show young girls that it's more than what you see that's posted on social media. So people pose and look all good and get the right angle before they post these pictures, but you have to know it's deeper than what it actually is. Now, she's on the cover of Vanity Fair, and woo, baby, talk about she is the It Girl, because that's what they name in that magazine right there, It Girl. Well, that the cover there, that is. She got a whole Marilyn Monroe thing going on. All I'm saying is it's good to see her doing better since she was battling depression and insecurities of herself. So for her modeling and having more celebrity friends, big ups to you. Keep it going. Stay positive. No matter what anyone says to you, you can do whatever you put your mind to. Now, the real question is, where is Prince Jackson and Blanket Jackson? I ain't saying nothing about them. Where y'all at? And now for our weather. Okay, my bad, y'all. Hold up. So, it's supposed to be raining. It never rains in Southern California. Oh, okay, sorry. So it's gonna be raining all weekend again, which means the dandelion is gonna be taller than a toddler. What the heck? So go ahead and get your lawnmowers ready for that. And your weed and feed. Anywho's, so next week it's supposed to be nice mid-60s, you know, temperature's pretty good. Don't bust out the shorts yet, but ladies, we do have to start shaving our legs on a regular basis. Damn. Oh, also, it's supposed to be 70 on Sunday. Pretty good, but it's supposed to be like 100% thunderstorm, so good luck enjoying that. Well, this week we've had some ups, we had some downs, we had some all arounds. We want to hear from you. Do you have any positive stories that you want us to share for you? Well, then hit us up. You know how to do it. Email, direct message, you can do it. All I'm saying is just holler at us. Also, we want to say a big shout out for our Legacy Barber College, which is located in Glenwood. So if you know someone who needs to go to barber school, hey, go ahead and hit my man Bobby up. We'll put his information down below. So, until next time, join the combo.